Hi everyone, welcome back to Sid's Killer Review, where this week we're reviewing No Country for Old Men, starring Javier Bardem. What was your overall impression of the film?
I liked it.
Why?
It's a very suspenseful movie. Mm-hmm. It's got good cinematography. The writing's really good.
Yeah. What would you rate it on a scale of 1 to 10 then?
A 9 out of 10.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, it's one of my, like, I like it a lot. I've seen it multiple times.
Yeah, this was my first time watching it.
What would you rate the movie?
I'd give it a 7. I think it was good, but I don't like... The ending really bothered me!
I loved the ending.
No, just the way they set it up, where you expect Moss, you expect him to live, get the money, and kill that guy. You expect the sheriff to not retire and solve the crime and arrest that guy. And you expect that guy, after the car accident, to get arrested and put in prison. Like the first scene, like how they say when he got arrested and then they said, yeah, you better lock me up because if you let me out, I'll just do it again. I thought that was foreshadowing of like, this is what's going to happen to this guy. This maniac, psychopath, killer.
I read that his betrayal of the character is the closest to a psychopath that's ever been in a movie.
Yeah, that's very clear. It's very evident that he's a psychopath. I mean, like, he's smart, but he's crazy. Like, whew. And everybody tells him that.
Every time I see it, I always think there's more coin flips.
Yeah.
He only does it twice. But in my mind, he's doing it all the time. I don't know why. But...
Yeah, like every decision he makes would be a coin flip.
I always forget that Woody Harrelson's in it.
Yeah, I didn't know he was. I also thought, just by seeing the cover of the movie, that they were going to be friends or something. Or that it was going to be three separate stories of older men living in Texas.
Okay, that makes sense.
And like how it's not fit for them.
You really didn't like the ending, did you?
No, I really hated it. It left me so unsettled and upset and irritated.
Because you wanted a good ending.
I did. And you think it could still go that way. I mean, Moss died, but you... still think, oh wait, the sheriff can change his mind after he talks to that guy he goes to visit, telling him that things are going to happen whether you can do something about it or not. I thought that was going to be like, oh, well, maybe I won't retire. And then he got in a car accident and I thought, oh, he's going to go catch him. And
yeah.
So there was still room to be resolved, but they didn't.
What was your favorite scene?
My favorite scene is one of the coin flip scenes where he's at the gas station with the old man.
Okay.
Before we knew that his coin flips determined if he was going to kill somebody or not, but you could still tell. And he's like a sweet little old man, so you're like, oh no, I hope he gets it. And then just the questioning, like, what am I betting on? Everything. There's everything to bet on. It was so weird, but... it was funny. Oh, don't put it in your pocket. That's your lucky quarter. And he's like, what do you want me to do with it? It's a quarter. It was just so funny to me. Well, he's got like crazy eyes.
Yeah, that, through the whole movie, I love it.
Yeah, his like mouth doesn't change at all, but his eyes are always like so open when he's struggling that cop. And his eyes are like...
yeah, in the very beginning.
Bugging out, yeah. It's creepy.
I can't remember if he won an award for that role.
It's an Oscar winning. I don't know if the film itself won or he won.
I guess it's Google time.
Academy Award for Best Picture. Academy Award for Best Writing, Best Director, Best Supporting Actor, Bardem. So he did. Okay, what didn't you like about the film?
The things I don't like about the film are the things that are different in the book, I guess. And so, some of the, like, the way the speeches are kind of mixed together. There's more of, like, Tommy Lee Jones' character. There's more of his, like, thoughts throughout the book.
Mm-hmm.
And they kind of mix them all together.
Yeah.
And so it feels like they try to squish it in, or it's just more timing things, I guess, than anything.
Yeah.
Because, like, it would get really boring to watch that if he's just, like, talking every 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Because that's what it would be like, I think.
Mm. What was your favorite scene?
I don't have one favorite scene. I like Tommy Lee Jones every time he talks, the sheriff.
Yeah.
He's always saying like these, the way he talks and the things he says are really funny, and it's always amused me. So I always like his responses and stuff.
Like when he's over explaining to the wife about the cattle guy, still can't pick up a cup of coffee, and it's like, what does that have to do with this?
Yeah. Or when, you know, they're like, the DEAs are down there and they're going to go look again. He's like, are they still dead? Yeah, well, guess he doesn't need me. Like, stuff like that, yeah. My favorite action scene, like, Moss is in the second hotel. Mm-hmm. And he knows he's coming.
Yeah.
Just because of the suspense.
That scene is really good.
Where he's, like,
really
waiting
good.
For him to see the feet.
Yeah.
And turns off the light in the hallway. Mm-hmm. So then he doesn't know when his feet, he can't see his feet anymore. And so it's like,
yeah.
I like that.
Yeah.
Because it's like, you know what he's doing.
That reminds me, I didn't like that literally in before it ends, when the sheriff, the other cop says to the sheriff, yeah, this guy likes to go back to the crime scene, so he gets it in his head that, oh, if I go to the crime scene now, he's gonna be there. He goes back, and you can see him through the lock that he blew out. You can see that guy's reflection, because he's hiding behind the door. And I also thought he was gonna kill the sheriff at that point, but...
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. They don't really go over that well in the movie of what happens.
Yeah.
So if we're just talking about the movie, is he actually in there? Is he still in there when the sheriff's in there?
Yeah.
And if he is, why doesn't he kill him?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's really confusing.
Yeah.
I know what you're saying.
Because he's not merciful. Like, he doesn't...
Exactly. So why did he not kill the sheriff?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Because he was the one person that was on his trail. Like, he had it all figured out. The sheriff had everything lined up. He knew what weapon he was using. They've known, like, they've followed his trail from those dead drug dealers all the way to that motel where Moss died. Like, he knows.
The only thing I can think of is he flipped a coin. But that would have been good for them to show it. Do you know what I mean? But you're right. That is, I think that is the worst scene in the whole movie. Because I've talked about it with other people. They're like, why didn't he kill him?
Yeah.
Shigar had every opportunity to kill the sheriff.
Mm-hmm.
And he doesn't. So.
Yeah.
And then they don't even really show that he's really still there.
Yeah, like if, like, he ducked out when he went
exactly.
in the bathroom. Or,
yeah, they show the door. The window was unlatched, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
So we have to assume, but they don't show it well. So.
Yeah. I think it was interesting, his weapon of choice. Like, I guess I get it because you can't trace, like, what bullets you were using to what gun, and then you can't find the gun anywhere if you use a air pressurized canister.
Him cleaning out his wound.
So gory. Oh!
That's a really good scene.
Yeah, like, oh, like, it looks so real. It's so bad. Oh. Stabbing himself, and he's...
He's pulling it out with tweezers. But he's, like, doing everything the right way, cleaning the tweezers, and he, like...
Iodine solution.
Yeah.
Yeah, everything.
Would you recommend this movie to other people?
Yeah. I think it's a good movie. There's just a lot of innocent people that die in this movie. Like, he kills at least three people on the highway. The guy with the chickens, the guy that he stole the first car, and...
Yeah, that's right.
Like, he's not merciful to people that don't deserve to die, I guess. I guess Moss deserved it, you know? He stole the money, he had it coming, you know? But, like, the guy with the chickens, what did he do, you know?
He stopped to help someone, that's even worse.
Yeah.
He kills the guy in the hotel.
Yeah. He kills the wife, even though the husband's dead. Like, what was the point of that?
He tells you in the movie.
I understand, to keep his word, but...
Yeah.
Do you think he killed the accountant, too, or no?
I don't know.
That's one I didn't know, either. Because doesn't he ask, are you going to shoot me? And then it cuts off.
Yeah.
So you don't know.
Yeah. I'd assume he's dead.
Probably. No, because he said, depends on if you see me or not.
Oh,
and then
yeah,
it's like,
still...
what do you say? Do you say, yes, I see you?
Oh,
does
okay.
it mean, like, do you see me as a person, or did you see me come in here and kill him?
But with that character, it could be either of
yeah,
those.
Yeah, I know. That's what I meant. That's why I was like, I don't, like, when he asked that, I was like, I don't know how I would answer that.
I would just walk away and hope for the best.
Yeah, I think either way, that guy was screwed.
Yeah. Can you imagine running into Shigar in real life? Like, with his crazy eyes. Like, oh my gosh.
No small talk with that guy.
I also really like the scene at the end when he gets in the car accident. His arm's broken and you see it sticking out.
Yeah.
Those kids.
The bone is sticking out of your arm. Yeah.
They're fighting over the money.
Yeah.
Half of that's mine.
You still have your shirt. Yeah. Yes. That reminds me of when Moss crosses the Mexican border and he walks past those kids and the one kid in the back asks twice, "Were you in an accident, mister?"
Are you in a car accident? Yeah. Yeah. I feel like that's realistic, though.
Yeah.
Like, there'd be this one kid hyperfixated
on. Yeah. Yeah, all he had to do to get back in, too, was say that he served in Vietnam. And they're like, all right.
Yeah, he asks him, like, what unit were you with? And he tells him, he's like, okay, let's get this man a ride. Yeah. That's what he does, right?
He gets him a ride to the clothes store, yeah.
And that guy's like, how's those boots working for you?
Yeah. He's like, you ever have somebody come in here without clothes? He goes, no, that's unusual.
Like, there's so many funny lines in a movie that is not funny at all.
Yeah.
There are all these funny lines that are just...
Yeah.
They're not funny, but they are. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's a lot of funny stuff in a movie that is just all about dying and killing you.
Yeah.
As assassins go, how do you think he is as an assassin? Chigar.
He's really good. Obviously. Like, he only gets hit once. And then... I don't know if Moss would have actually been able to kill him. If the cartel wouldn't have taken him out, if they had stood off, like, I don't know if he would have succeeded.
I don't think he would have.
No.
Even Woody Harrelson's character is like, you're out of your league kind of thing.
Do you think Woody's character would have actually helped Moss or no?
No.
You think he still would have killed him?
I don't think he would have killed him, but I don't think he would have helped him.
Like, given him money, you mean?
I don't think he would have done anything. I think he would have just taken the money and left.
Hmm.
That's another great scene when Chigar killed the guy that Woody hires Woody.
Oh, yeah, and he just walks in. He just walks in. Yeah.
And then he's, like, looking at the body, and then he's faced away from the accountant. He's like, who are you?
Yeah, I didn't know he was talking to that guy.
Yeah, no, I think that's great. I think that's, like, one of those good psychopath moments of, like, wow, this guy's just...
totally not in society.
Something's wrong with him, yeah.
Yeah. You stand to win everything. Call it. All right. Heads then. Well done. Don't put it in your pocket. It's your lucky quarter. Where do you want me to put it? Anywhere not in your pocket. Otherwise, it will just be mixing with the others and become a coin. Which it is.